right, so I screwed up after my first, it's the introduction to Gridania, basically, video, where you go through, you've watched the opening sequence movies, you've gone through those cutscenes, and you've entered Gridania, and you've done the first quest, which is just like, hey you, you're new here, go talk to this main quest giver in this town. That's what I meant. And then I messed up, like, talking to her the second time for the new quest, so here's what that dialogue is like. Mother me. The video ensues. Let us begin at the beginning, shall we? Now that you are a formal member of the Adventurers Guild, you must be sure you have a firm grasp of the fundamentals of adventuring. To that end, I have three tasks I wish you to perform. I recreated this character to do this because I fucked up the first time, just by the way. Your first task is to visit the Aetherite, This massive crystal stands in the middle of the Aetherite Plaza, not far from the Carline Canopy. As the device that enables instantaneous transportation, the Aetherite plays a key role in the life of the ever-wandering adventurer. Once you have located the crystal, all you need to do is touch its surface, and a member of the Woodwithers will present to offer further instruction. For your second task, you are to visit the Lancers Guild, because I chose Lancers by starting the job. There is no better place to learn the arts of the pole arm. Speak with Jillian, and she will explain the benefits of joining the guild. For your third and final task, I would have you visit the markets at the heart of Old Gridania's commercial district. There, you shall find weapons and armor, and all the various items that an adventurer might need on her travels. There is, however, more to the markets than buying and selling goods. Speak with Parsimontret, and listen well to his counsel. They make these names super fun to pronounce. The master merchant can be uncooperative at times, so be sure to offer him one of my famous eel pies. No, thank you. That sounds weird. I do like eel and sushi, but that's not anyway, like so many men, he is much more charitable when his stomach is full. True of women, too, like, come on. Here. Give me the batch. Not love that. You have your tasks, Mercy. May Nofika guide your path. Again, Nofika is goddess of war. One more thing. Should you happen to come across any citizens in need, don't be afraid to prefer a helping hand. I'm certain they will be pleased to meet an adventurer in whom they can confide their woes. Granted, the work they offer is unlikely to be of realm-shattering importance, but prove your worth and build a reputation, and in time, folk will be more inclined to trust you with matters of moment. I heard the term matters of moment as they kind of describing things that are actually important. I also suggest that you lend an ear to the smith here in the canopy. The smiths are trusted representatives of the Adventurers Guild, and are an invaluable source of advice for neophyte heroes seeking to gain greatness. And she looks over at this green robed, I think kind of pointy, but yeah, a little pointy, but it seems more human than elven. Or elfin, whatever. I don't know what they're called in this game. They're elven in Final Fantasy. He resides in this. Seems like a trainer of some sort. I have accepted the quest close to home.
Running
walking through this forested town, not a lot of trees that you run across in the town have been cleared deep paths. But there's like this like tiny shallow lake in the middle of this part of town that is the main part of town with the giant crystal lake. The rotating blue tall crystal lake covering the crystal base. And there's a gold ring, some crystals protruding from it, some blue crystals protruding from it that counter rotates basically. And also kind of the ring that goes up and down in its rotation, whereas the crystal. Greetings, adventurer. I see you are faithfully following my moon. This is Alicia. Yeah. Allow me to offer you a bit of instruction myself. I am Alicia with the wood rangers, and I know a thing or two about the aetherite. Yes, that big crystal ring. Aetherites are devices that tap into the ethereal entities. They're primarily used as a means to travel swiftly from one place to another. Return and teleport. The most common transportation spells make direct use of the aetherites and their connection to the flow of aether. And as these devices are found in almost every corner of the Gridania, any adventurer worthy of the name will wish to seek out the tools of its wonders. Truly, few things in this world are as useful to the interpreters. But you need not look at them all at once. Before rushing out into the wilds, I suggest you start with the aetherites around the area. Should you wish to learn more about the aetherite or transportation magic, I am here to answer your question. Alicia is one of those wood mirrors with a great armor and some hair. She has dark hair, almost like me. I find myself in the market, which is a long wooden structure. Master of the markets. You think you can stroll in here, bold as you please, and demand my heart of knowledge? Ha! A merchant does not for naught, especially when dealing with wood here. If, on the other hand, you had some tasty morsel to curry my favor, then I might consider your request. Come now, this whole encounter reeks of Mune's handiwork. And more specifically, her bacon. Don't look so over-surprised, lass. I smelled that eel pie of yours a long way. Anyway, this is where you learn how to cook. He has glasses, too. He looks boring. Or just fed up. That flaky crust just divine. Very well. I'm a man of my word. Pay close attention, for I shall only explain this once. The aspiring adventurer needs look no further than the rosewood and ebony stalls. Both are but a short stroll from where we stand. If you mean to do battle, you'd best be prepared with a quality set of weapons and armor. Kind of see down one aisle with all the stalls in there. Such goods are the province of the Rosewood Stalls, directly south of here. You would be pleased to learn that the merchants of Gridania are exceedingly particular when it comes to craftsmanship, so you needn't fear defective straps and the like. If it is potions and paraphernalia you seek, head north to the Ebony Stalls, and you'll see down the other row of stalls. The shelves there are lavishly stocked by widely traveled and old dawn merchants. And I may truly say that I've seen things amongst their myriad wares that I scarcely existed. Do you follow me thus far? The first step in any purchase is to select the stalls that meet your needs. Then you may concern yourself with pricing. There's little more I can teach you with mere words. Go, peruse the stalls, and see for yourself what wares they offer. There's no substitute for first-hand experience, after all. And I'm weary of talking. Unless you have oh cool, then your quest. Yep, okay, never mind. I'm gonna go grab the paper for the answer story. Nope. Not here. Leather works still, but it's not shaded gold. This is the market. Solar sign. Tunes in the Aether Shard. Aether Shard. Interest Guild is just another fairly nondescript. What a weird kind of face mask on it. Just a wooden structure with pole arms and tridents and such, kind of adorning it. Inside we talk to Jilly. Welcome to the Lancer's Guild. I see you brought your own spear. If you seek to refine your skills with the pole arm, then you've come to the right place. Here the Lancer's Guild spear wielders gather to train with one another, and further hone their abilities under the tutelage of refining instructors. More than just an instrument of war, the spear is also a tool for hunting, and with game ever plentiful in the 12th wood, the weapon has been a mainstay of the locals. Since before the founding of Gridania. With the passing of time, our nation became a gathering place for spearmasters from across the realm, many eager to test their mettle against the famed might of our wood wielders. And it was here in Gridania that their myriad fighting styles came into contact, eventually giving rise to the art taught here today. The spear technique could be formalized at all. That spear technique could be formalized at all. Owed much to the founding of the Lancers Guild by Woodwheeler Captain Mistal. Nine a century passed. The tradition of accepting students from without as well as within Gridania's borders persists to this day, ensuring that the art of polar may not only survive, but also continue to evolve. Well, there you have it. I hope this brief history of the guild has helped to settle any doubts in your mind. The Lancers Guild has always been good to welcome new initiatives. If you've a will to enlist, please speak with me again and we can begin the enrollment procedures. I'm gonna do that later, because I'm on a quest. I'm doing one quest at a time. can use these aetherite. Yes, there are starter quests. End of recording.